From Anderson Fieldhouse at Fort Eustis, WHGS Cable Channel 5 presents Bliss the District Girls Championship Game. The Hampton Crabbers versus the Menchville Monarchs. Good evening, everybody. I'm Tim Cole, along with Bob Hintz. We welcome you to Fort Eustis, to Anderson Fieldhouse, for the game between the Hampton Crabbers, the Lady Crabbers, 13-10, and the Menchville Monarchs, 23-0. Right now, let's go to courtside. Bob Hintz has head coach David Six of the Hampton Crabbers.
Thanks, Tim. David, congratulations on your win. You're going to the regionals, but now you can play a pretty tough team in this Menchville team.
Oh, they're probably the best team in the state. They're so deep. I mean, they have so many great players. I mean, from one to maybe player 12, any of those girls can start on other teams in the district.
Well, and plus, you have only gone with eight all year. They will weigh you down if nothing else.
That's right. They're so deep, and they want to turn the volume up on you. They want to press, run. They can get you tired.
Well, listen, you did a great job over there. You're going to the regionals. Play loose tonight.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Good enough. And, again, congratulations.
Thanks.
Okay, let's go back over to Tim.
All right, Bob, thank you. And, again, our congratulations to David Six, just in his second year as the coach over at Hampton High School. And the Crabbers, the Lady Crabbers, first time since 1977 that they're going to be involved in regional play. So our hats off to David Six. He's just done a phenomenal job with that team. Let's go back to courtside now as Bob Hintz has head coach Phil Forbes of the Menchville Monarchs.
Thanks, Tim. Phil, congratulations. Undefeated season so far. You're the class of the peninsula, and most people say you're one of the top in the state.
Well, I hope to think we are, but the kids have worked as hard to get to where we're at today, and they're confident, they're prepared. Achievements you just don't back into. These kids have earned them, and with a good state of mind and work ethics, and hopefully we'll continue to keep going.
Well, I've watched you play a few times and talked to other coaches, and they say you like the pressure defense, the up-tempo, and just take the other team out of the rhythm.
Our style is to get up and get after you, and hopefully our defensive pressure will kind of make you get out of your game, and that our defensive pressure usually is our best offensive game.
Well, listen, congratulations, and good luck in the regional.
Thank you very much.
Okay, Phil, let's go back over to Tim.
All right, Bob, thank you, and again, our congratulations. Phil Forbes' squad undefeated, and they are headed to the regionals. As we mentioned, both of these teams will go to regional postseason play, the Hampton Crabbers and Menchville. The game will not determine any seedings. It is simply for the championship of the Peninsula District. Right now, we're back across the court to
Bill Nelson. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and on behalf of the Virginia High School League and the Peninsula District, we would like to welcome you to Anderson Fieldhouse here at Fort Eustis, Virginia. The finals tonight for the Peninsula District Tournament, the championship games, game number one, the team seeded number one. The undefeated Lady Monarchs of Menchville will be playing host to the team seeded number three in the tournament, the Lady Crabbers of Hampton.
Tim, he's going
at
to
this time, ladies and gentlemen, in honor
tonight
of this great country in which we all work and play, I'd like to ask if you would all rise and stand, please, for the playing of our national anthem.
Thank you.
and gentlemen, for both of these teams to arrive at this point, it has taken a total team effort. And tonight, rather than just simply announce the starters, we would like to take this opportunity to introduce the entire squads for the two teams that are playing here this evening. First of all, the Lady Crabbers and their reserves. Number 12, Tanisha McDonald. Number 14, Carrie Melvin. Number 20, Alinda Mock. Number 23, Katrina Fennell. Number 30, Terry Smith. Number 33, Leslie Jones. Number 42, Lakina Parker. And number 52, Nicole Heath. And now for the Lady Monarchs of Benchville, the reserves. Number 10, Karen Felix. Number 14, Carol Williams. Number 22, Amika Perry. Number 23, Danielle Dawson. Number 24, Candace Edwards. Number 30, Shannon Bucher. Number 34, Joy Streeter. Number 42, Tiffany Atwater. And number 44, Rihanna Williams. And now for the starting lineup for tonight's teams. At forward, a 5'10" junior for the Lady Crabbers of Hampton, number 34, Stephanie Hicks. At forward, a 5'11" senior for the Lady Monarchs of Benchville, number 3, Misty Hart. At forward, a 5'10" junior for the Lady Crabbers of Hampton, number 10, Latoya Lassiter. At forward, a 5'11" junior for the Lady Monarchs of Benchville, number 32, Wanda Artis. At guard, a 5'5" senior for the Hampton Lady Crabbers, number 50, Tori Howard. At center, a 6'1" freshman for the Lady Monarchs of Benchville, number 33, Chiloa Slias. At guard, a 5'9" junior for the Lady Crabbers of Hampton, number 44, Shonda Bailey. At guard, a 5'10" senior for the Benchville Lady Monarchs, number 5, Patricia Dixon. At guard, a 5'6" junior for the Lady Crabbers of Hampton, number 32, Nikisha Gilliam. And at guard, a 5'11" senior for the Benchville Lady Monarchs, number 21, Colleen Holcraft. Head coach for the Lady Crabbers in his second season is David Six. He is assisted by Larry Shields. Head coach for the Lady Monarchs of Benchville in his third year is Phil Forbes. He is assisted by Carol Williams, Brad Forbes, and Andrea Spruill. Our officials this evening, the referee, Ron Ellis, the umpire, Mr. Doug Diggs.
All right, I think we've finally got our microphone back. Yep. The old Dems covered everything except the guy that sweeps the floors between the games.
Well, we do need to thank the people here, Tim. Mike Cicero, Don Tillman, and Ron Lynch all helping us set up here at Anderson Fieldhouse. We're going to see a very up-tempo game as far as the Benchville Monarchs go. You'll notice that Danielle Dawson is not playing. She is sick, as you see the officials on the screen there. But they will try to run. They'll try to get easy baskets off of turnovers on their press. That's the way they play all year.
It's quite a shame that Danielle Dawson won't be able to play because she really is one of the best players in the Peninsula District. She came on last year as a transfer and really added a great dimension to Phil's already strong team then.
And she really did, and you notice right away they're in a man-to-man full court. And they're going to pressure you, try to make you turn the ball over. Hampton has got a real lot of help bringing the ball up now from Gilliam and Howard. They've both done a real good job. But they're going to have to look at scoring. And there's the one you try to get the ball to. Stephanie Hicks missed that shot.
And the Monarchs almost turn it over, but they do not. Scoreless just underway from Fort Eustis Anderson Fieldhouse. Just to remind you, a couple of the differences in high school basketball, 8-minute quarters and no shot clock. Those are the two major differences. We see a stoppage in play as Torrey Howard of Hampton has committed the first foul of the ball game. It'll be a player control foul. And each team will be in a non-shooting situation, except for the obvious case where they're fouled in the act of shooting, until the team registers 7 team fouls. On the 7th and all subsequent fouls, the 1-and-1 effect. With Benchfield with the ball.
Tim, you'll notice that Hampton is in a zone. He has played with 8 players almost the whole season. The girls, the extra ones he's got on the bench, he brought up from the JVs. And it makes a big difference when you don't have as much depth.
Nice pass underneath from Misty Hart. The pass going to Wanda Artis as she didn't get the shot to go, but she drew the foul.
Misty Hart, I think, has already signed to go to Old Dominion. Is quite a ball player.
Latoya Lassiter is called for the personal. Her first, the second team foul against Hampton. At the free throw line will be Wanda Artis.
You'll see that this Minchville team is a very unselfish team. They will pass the ball. Misty had a good 8-foot jumper and then hit the young lady for the layup. So you can notice that that's one of the philosophies of Coach Forbes is we will give up a good shot for a better shot.
Wanda Artis with 10 points her last timeout against Lafayette, a game that, as Hampton turns the ball over, a game that Minchville won handily against a pretty good Lafayette girls team. They held that team to 17 points while scoring 76 of their own. So this Minchville team can not only pour the points on the board, but they play good D as well. And as I say that, they turn the ball over.
Well, and you have to understand that they're playing without their point guard and one of the best players in the state, Danielle Dawson. And you got Misty Hart, who can handle the ball, but in a position that she normally does not play.
A veteran team on the floor for Phil Forbes. Down low, and Lassiter's shot is too strong, but Stephanie Hicks with the offensive board, and she'll set it back up. Shanda Bailey, rather quiet the other night in the victory over Phoebus, so if they happen to get a little scoring from her, that'll certainly improve their opportunities. Down the baseline, Lassiter's shot again, a little too strong, but it was knocked out of bounds by a Minchville Monarch.
Well, Hampton is trying to get the ball inside. That's where they have their best scoring possibility. They're not a great outside shooting team. I don't know how you call that traveling. She didn't do it. She didn't roll or anything. If it was traveling, it was when she first got the ball. I don't understand that call.
Loose ball, finally controlled by the Lady Crabbers.
I'm real impressed with the freshman, number 33, Chaloas. Last, Tim, she shot and was right back up, getting a rebound. Very quick coming back up.
David Six, very quick to tell you that his team, although only 13-10, is 8-2 in their last 10 games. So they are a team that has been coming on, and they'll have their hands full tonight. As we'll see, the first substitution of the ball game in the game for Hampton will come number
33.
Yeah, find me a 33 here, Bob.
Leslie Jones.
Leslie Jones, I had her as 53. Okay, good. Well, we got a name to go with a number.
Now,
that's
all. You can't say that's my writing, Tim.
No.
That's pre-printed.
Shot is short, and Stephanie Hicks comes out of the pack. Talking with a couple of my coworkers today about this Hampton team, and the name Stephanie Hicks came up because this young lady impressed those fellas that are, you know, just kind of new at watching girls basketball, but they've seen a couple of games, and they said that what impressed them most about her is she stopped playing only when the final whistle blows, because she is in the game all 32 minutes.
And this is one thing that Coach Six told me. He says she has probably got the best work ethic of any ball player he's ever coached or been around. She really works hard to improve her game in all aspects of the game. And you're right, she doesn't stop playing until the final whistle. I don't care what the score is.
So very very dedicated player, and it's shown in her scoring. She's averaging almost 19 points a game. So great career for Stephanie Hicks over at Hampton High School. 4:40 left in a just 2-0 game. Kind of a surprise here. The game has no meaning as far as seedings in the regional play. Certainly each team wants to win the Peninsula District Championship, so there's no pressure to win in order to go on. And really, I thought by now we'd see 20 or 25 points on the board, at least in the first quarter. Well, but both teams playing tight.
Well, and one of the reasons that Hampton not scoring is because of the defense of the Menchville Monarchs, but without their normal point guard in there, I'm sure that they're they feel a little different than being the Menchville Monarchs.
Monarchs getting plenty of opportunities on the offensive board. They just can't get the shot to go down.
That's 4 or 5 offensive rebounds. A great job by number 10, Latoya Lassiter. Tim, she's, David Six says, his best defensive ball player.
Shot off the mark. Stephanie Hicks with the offensive rebound. This is Tori Howard. She'll kick it out to Nakisha Gilliam. And she has turned into a real fine ball handler, Nakisha is. Lassiter fouled on the shot. She'll get 2 chances. The foul will be called against number 33, Chalois Leos. And she is just a freshman, 6'1" tall. And boy, is she a great prospect for Phil Forbes for 3 more years.
Oh, you got that right. Tim, with more than 4 minutes gone, half of this first quarter gone, no field goals. The 2 points up there on the board are from free throws.
Lassiter hits the free throw. And certainly your observation that one of the key players for Menchville is not in there, Danielle Dawson, but still they've got plenty of support. These girls just haven't been able to find the range yet, but that'll happen, I'm sure. And at the other end of the court, a foul and a shooting opportunity coming as Lassiter hit one of the 2 free throws.
That's on Lassiter. I believe that's her second one.
Katrina Fennell comes in for Lassiter at the free throw line. Is Patricia Dixon, and she is unable to hit the first of 2. There you see a good look at Patricia.
Katrina Fennell, Tim, 6', just a sophomore, so Coach Six will have her for 2 more years.
1 of 2 for Dixon, and the lead is back to a 2-point difference. Full court pressure being applied by the Lady Monarchs. There is a 10-second timeline in the high school game, and they do get it across the timeline. Shanda Bailey has the dribble knocked away. The ball was knocked into the backcourt by a Lady Monarch, so no violation. Tori Howard double teamed, and that defense working for the Monarchs. Shot no good. Gilliam with the rebound. So the lid continues to be clamped tightly on both baskets. And the turnover back over to the Monarchs. 3 minutes to go. Just 3-1. Monarchs. Misty Hart 4-3. No good. Just off the rim. And a tie up. The possession error will give the ball over to the Crabbers. And David Six would like to take a timeout, and he will do so with 2:54 remaining in the first period. Score, Menchville 3, Hampton 1.
And Tim, we would like to thank DC Engraving and the Sports Place for helping us recognize a player of the game from the Hampton Crabbers tonight with the plaque and a shirt. DC Engraving, located at Tab Square on Route 17, also does color copies, and that's David Buckwalder out there. The Sports Place is where we hit the shirt. That is located at Hampton Woods Plaza on Big Bethel Road, and Dave Chubb is out there along with Brian Cartwright and Coach White, Bruce Hatch, George Baker, just to name a few. A lot of people out there to help those guys, but we appreciate all that effort that they do, helping us recognize a player of the game for the Hampton team.
We want to remind you that we will also have here on Channel 5 the boys game pitting the Kickitan Warriors against the Ferguson Mariners. That game will follow this one here at Fort Eustis, and we'll have it for you here on Channel 5 in its entirety. And that'll be game four between those two teams. Ferguson having won two of the first three, including a playoff last week for the top seed. Revenge will be the key for Kickitan, and all those games have been decided by two or less points. Bentzville finally gets the basket to count. That's Carol Williams with the first two-pointer.
And the defense is causing the Crabbers to turn the ball over.
Driving the lane, and the foul is going to be on Gilliam. That was one to Artis with the ball. So 32, fouling number 32. That'll be a player control foul, as Artis was not in the act of shooting. It is, however, the fourth team foul against Hampton. Stephanie Hicks with a good defense. All right, coach.
So you just gotta have the ball knows who to come to.
That's right. As long as it doesn't hit my drink on the table. Latoya Lassiter is going to check back in for Hampton, replacing Fennell. From 15, no good. Stephanie Hicks with the rebound. And again, the intense pressure being applied by the Monarchs. Shannon Bircher in the game now, number 30. She's guarding Shanda Bailey. Phil Forbes going to his very deep bench early here. Gilliam gets it to Hicks down low. Hicks off the glass.
Is that a nice turnaround jumper? She is sweet.
And that gives Menchville now a two-point lead, 5-3. A minute and a half to go in the first. Stolen momentarily by Gilliam, but regained by the Monarchs. This is Carol Williams as they move the ball down low and they throw it away.
Well, the reason that was thrown away is the passer had to get it over Stephanie Hicks and just threw it too hard.
Double team in the backcourt and a foul will be called. That'll be charged against Shannon Bircher, number 30. That'll be her first.
Foul will be against the Lady Monarchs, number 30, Shannon Bircher.
It'll be a non-shooting foul. And now Menchville will bring Misty Hart back into the lineup, replacing Bircher. You're watching the championship game of the Peninsula District Girls Tournament. Tim Cole with Bob Hintz, happy to bring you this game. From Anderson Fieldhouse.
A little ragged, but the pressure defensively will cause the play to be ragged occasionally.
Well, defense and pressure are two words that are the trademark of Phil Forbes' Menchville team. And the turnover gives the ball back to the Monarchs with 47 seconds to go.
What really hurts a team, Tim, like that is it takes you out of your rhythm. And I know right now the Hampton girls feel there's no rhythm, that they're getting no flow at all.
And that is Lias, Jalois Lias for two, her first basket. And again, the steal. Feet underneath for Hart, too strong. And Stephanie Hicks with one of several rebounds she has so far. Hampton had a two-on-one. Now they keep it going as Lassiter goes to the hoop but can't get it to drop. Just a little too strong. Misty Hart feed left side. Put it up. No good. Rebound was in the hands of Lias, and she is fouled. I believe that'll be number three on Lassiter.
But I'm impressed with the way Chalois gets up in the air. I mean, she goes up and back. She comes down and is back up again. She is such a quick leaper.
So that gives David six headaches because he has to take Lassiter out now with three personals, and his bench is only three deep to begin with. 4 seconds remaining, and Hampton steals the inbounds pass, and before they can do anything with it, the sound of the buzzer tells us that the first period is over, and a very low-scoring first period, particularly for the Monarchs, who are known to put points on the board. They lead just 7-3 after the first 8 minutes of action. Right now, let's let you look at the cheerleaders from Hampton High School. Let's see if our director can get a little shot of that, and we'll let you listen in as well.
Man sitting there, one of the assistant coaches for the football team at the Hampton High. Just a great young man.
14 in the first quarter. So Hampton, with the second quarter set to begin, will be without the starter Latoya Lassiter. She has three personal fouls, so they will find themselves missing the young lady who was our pick for the player of the game against Phoebus the other night. So a big problem for David Six. Foul in the traffic, and we'll see.
David Six is really hot on the side there. The young lady from Edgeville, Pachalis, is triple teamed, and she's still got the ball.
Nakisha Gilliam called for her second personal foul. That's the sixth team foul against Hampton. So on the next foul and all subsequent fouls here in the first half, the Monarchs will have a one-and-one situation. Wanda Artis, after hitting her first two free throws, misses on her third attempt.
Tim, she was falling backwards when she shot it that time. You got to stay where you are and not fall backwards when you shoot. That's a much better shot.
And the result's much better as well, as she hits it and gives her team a 5-point lead. Yet a new tandem of camera people here tonight, a little short-handed for the first game. Jerome Young giving you the shot you're seeing right now from our baseline camera. Scotty Bowers, our resident expert director, doing his usual great job.
We got Earl Davenport on one of the other cameras and Trevor Glass on the other one.
And we've got a foul away from the ball. This will go against Wanda Artis. Director told me something. Say that again, please, Scotty. Oh, yeah, don't forget the girl that puts a score up there once in a while.
Oh.
Miss Petaway.
Oh, yes, Bianca.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, don't forget her. A Newport News fan, I understand. Now, I caught a little grief myself about the second game tonight. My son goes to Ferguson, so I've got to watch what I say.
Yes, you better.
Eight to three with 7:22 left in the first half. And again, another offensive board for Stephanie Hicks, but she can't get it to go. And back come the Monarchs, got a 3-on-1. And good D by Shanda Bailey.
Man, that was, Tim, that should have been, oh, there's Hicks down the court. She missed her. Great job. Looked like it was gonna be a layup for the Monarchs.
They get it to Hicks. She's down low. She puts it up a little too strong. Follow-up shot, no good. And back come the Monarchs. And a pushing foul as Colleen Holcraft was headed to the basket. And a Lady Craver impeded her progress. see who the call goes against. That'll be charged to Katrina Fennell.
Was that Fennell?
Number 23.
Oh.
So that'll be 32. 1-1.
I transposed my numbers. I thought it was 32.
Holcraft will get the bonus. Colleen Holcraft, she has been with the Mintzville team now a starter, if not a consistent contributor for a number of years, averaging better than 13 points a game. Colleen Holcraft, and she is a senior. She will not be around after this year. Nor will the young lady with the ball now, Misty Hart. Shot in and out. And lost on the baseline by Lias. If you look at Phil Forbes' squad, he will have some real good players back again next year. Danielle Dawson, Wanda Artis will be back, Shannon Bircher. Of course, the Chalois Lias is just a freshman. And among the players that see a lot of action as we have a timeout being called. Misty Hart will be gone. Karen Felix will be gone. Patricia Dixon. Tiffany Atwater. Colleen Holcraft. Amiko Perry. And Rihanna Williams will all be graduating. But he'll still have a very fine nucleus to start from.
Oh, I tell you, you got a great guard in Danielle and a young lady underneath the basket, 6'1", just a freshman, Chalois Lias, and she's 6'1", in the freshman team. You know she's not done growing yet.
And on the other side for David Six, he has some real bright stars coming back too. His only loss this year of players will be Tori Howard. And everybody else will be back. We got Chanda Bailey as a junior, Stephanie Hicks is a junior, Nakisha Williams is a junior, Leslie Jones, junior, and Latoya Lassiter is just a sophomore. And a rising junior varsity team. The junior varsity team got off to a slow start this year, but they finished strong. I was talking with David before the game, and things are very bright on the horizon for the Hampton Lady Crabbers. Their first appearance in regional play since 1977. That's coming up next week. Right now, they're in the Peninsula District Championship hunt. And that is Lias who scores. It's 12-3. So 5 points here in the second period to none for the Crabbers. So the Crabbers need to get on track. They've gotten the ball down low to Stephanie, just like they did there, but she's been unable to hit, and she misses again. Follow shot, no good. And chased down by the ever-present Stephanie Hicks. So that never-give-up attitude paid off again.
Boy, it did that time because it didn't look like she was going to have the ball.
Good feed from Howard, and Hicks
great.
Scores.
That's a tough pass, but it was just right where Stephanie could get a hold of it.
First points of the second quarter for the Crabbers. And on the baseline, it's knocked out of bounds by Hampton. David Six, as you see him in your picture there, constantly coaching.
Freshman.
Chalois Lias with three baskets now. And them coming from outside. She is just a freshman, 6'1". She's still growing. Shanda Bailey has the shot rejected. Misty Hart off the glass for two.
Tori Howard did all she could without fouling her, got in front of her, but Misty Hart is quite a ball player. As I had alluded to earlier, she is going to ODU on a basketball scholarship.
Patricia Dixon with a little too much contact. That'll be the fourth team foul against Mintzville. Will not be a shooting situation. Shanda Bailey, who has yet to score for the Crabbers, and she truly is the second most potent scorer on this team as a rule, averaging almost 10 points a game. Hicks, shot no good, got her own rebound, put it back up, got it, and drew the foul.
Yeah, got a chance for the three-point play, and I tell you, she never quits, Devin, as you had talked about earlier, just keeps going and keeps going and keeps, misses a shot, gets a rebound, fakes, puts it back up, draws a foul, gets the basket.
And Stephanie Hicks will go to the line and attempt to get the three-point play.
Foul is charged against Wanda Artis. Cuts the lead to a 9-point difference. Grabbers got off to a slow start here in the second period.
Well, part of that is because of the defense that they are experiencing. And right now, Stephanie is taking a little break, tying her shoes, catching her breath. That's not a bad move.
Travers get the offensive board. Shanda Bailey puts it in.
Four straight points, big break. Nice rebound by youngest Bailey.
Lead is 7. Hicks had the board, couldn't hold it. Leos got it, missed it. And a foul on Hicks. She was a little too aggressive. And again, with the 1-1 in effect. Misty Hart will step to the free throw line, averaging more than 15 and a half points a game here in her senior
watch
year.
Watch her, Tim. She has tremendous concentration on her foul shots. Just a great, great concentration, follow through. She does it all.
While I'm spewing these statistics out to you, I do want to tell you where we get them. That's from the Daily Press, the sports department. The writers up there, headed up by Mike Keach and Jennifer Williams, who handle the high school beat as a rule. And, of course, all of the writers there contribute to the statistics. Tony Anthony, Eric Pugh, Sonny Dirth, on and on. A lot of fine writers. Daily Press sports department, we really appreciate their help in bringing you these games.
Well, Stephanie Hicks missed the first one, got her own rebound and put it back up.
She's got to have almost a dozen rebounds just here in the first half. Nice read.
Great pass from Misty Hart.
Wanda Artis with the bucket. Stephanie Hicks having some difficulty with the pressure, but is able to get it to a teammate. 19-11. 3:15 to go, and Hicks is picking up the pace here. She has 10 points, and the difference is a 6-point lead for Mitchville, and now Phil Forbes would like to take a timeout.
Tim, I'll tell you why the Crabbers are scoring now. The off people who are not on the ball are setting picks and screens for the ball carrier, which breaks open and gives them a better look at passing the ball into the people underneath the basket. Preferably, you're going to get it to Stephanie Hicks, but if you don't screen for the ball, the dribbler, they can't see what's going on. Tim, you got the ball over there?
Not me. It's down here by my feet, but I
don't see it.
It was here a minute ago.
There it is.
Five left here in the first half. Mitchville with a 6-point lead. There you see us sitting like a little island out here in the middle of the center of the court. Just you and me and a TV screen.
And we appreciate it. Nice defense by Tori Howard.
Travers got a Got to stay close if they can here. Stephanie Hicks can't get to the rebound. Back come the Lady Monarchs. Misty Hart holds it up. Holcraft, her pass intercepted by Howard. A foot race as Howard has it blocked. Leos getting back on defense, and then the Monarchs were able to hold on to it.
Great job of cutting off the baseline that time by Stephanie Hicks.
Holcraft can't get the shot to go. Hicks knocked to the floor and no foul was called.
I'm not sure I believe that call, no call.
Pass intercepted on the inbounds play. Hart, baseline jumper, no good. And knocked out of bounds, last touched by a Hampton player.
Misty Hart wants to come out, Tim. When she ran into Stephanie Hicks that time, I think she got the worst of it, even though Stephanie went down.
In the lineup now is Carol Williams, number 14, replacing Hart. Holcraft to Leas. Holcraft put it up, kind of an awkward shot. Got her own rebound. Very physical game between these two teams. There's a lot of contact, and we've got a jump ball. The shot will not count. Jump ball will give the ball to the Lady Crabbers on the possession arrow.
David Six is putting in last of the Tim with 1:36 to go in the first half with three fouls. I kind of question that. They're playing well without her, and you don't want her to pick up her fourth foul.
And the Crabbers turn it over, and then the Menchville Monarchs return the favor. Patricia Dixon took a step. One too many, I guess I should say. Monarchs are really making it tough on Hampton's inbound pass. They're really having a tough time.
Well, they're not setting any good screens.
Misty Hart will come back in for Phil Forbes' Menchville Monarchs. And that means Shannon Bircher will check out.
Hart replaces number 30, Sharon Bucher.
See, Menchville knows that the Crabbers are going to get the ball back to Shonda Bailey, and so they just really are waiting for that pass to go back to her.
Double team on Hicks. She's able to get the ball to Howard. I tell you, this Menchville defense just presses you and presses you. Shonda Bailey with the shot.
Oh, and that was great job because the shot was blocked prior to that.
The lead is just 4 points now. Crabber staying close. And a jump ball is called.
Well, it was either jump ball or traveling.
Looking back at the games earlier between these two teams, Menchville won handily at Hampton 54-25. And handily at Menchville, 74-37. And the turnover gives the ball to Hampton. Give it right back. And Hart double dribbled and gave it right back. So very sloppy game between two much better teams than we're seeing. Lassiter's pass for Torrey Howard is knocked away by Holcraft. And last touch by the Monarch. Not sure what her point was. She clearly knocked the ball out of bounds.
Well, she didn't. She thought she hit it off of Torrey Howard, but she didn't.
Less than a minute to go now, 40 seconds and counting. Grabbers only down by two baskets. But they turn it over once again, and Misty Hart, with good speed, lays it in.
You got to know where the defense is behind you, and that time, Shonda Bailey was not paying attention to where the rest of the players were.
And Hicks with the interception. 8 seconds to go. Torrey Howard is now aware of the time of running out and was unable to get a shot away before the buzzer sounds. So we have reached halftime, and our score at halftime, Mansfield 21, the Lady Crabbers of Hampton 15. We'll return to Anderson Fieldhouse for the third period of action after this brief timeout. At halftime, our score, the Lady Monarchs of Mansfield 21, the Hampton Crabbers, the Lady Crabbers 15. The leading scorer for the Crabbers at halftime and for the game for that matter, Stephanie Hicks with 10 points all from the field. And to go along with her 10 points, she also has 10 rebounds. 4 points for Shanda Bailey on two baskets and 1 point for Latoya Lassiter, who has three fouls, and she is the only Lady Crabber or Mansfield Monarch with more than two. For the Mansfield Monarchs, they were paced by Chloas Lias, who had 6 points, and she also led her team with four rebounds. 5 points for Misty Hart, two baskets and one of two free throws. 2 points, and check that, 5 points also for Wanda Artis, and she had a basket and three of four free throws. 2 points for Colleen Holcraft, as well as Carol Williams, and 1 point for Patricia Dixon on one of two free throws. 21-15, the score at halftime. David Six's Lady Crabbers within striking distance of the Mansfield Monarchs, and certainly without too much emphasis on this, the Lady Monarchs are decimated by some illnesses, not the least of which is Danielle Dawson, who is out six, and I believe you mentioned, Bob, there are four other young ladies also.
Tiffany Atwater, number 42, 55, Amy Hemlack, Angela Jordan, and Andy Petrie.
So five players on the sidelines, either out of the game or at least suffering illness that might prevent them from playing tonight. The Lady Monarchs get the first opportunity of the second half. They cannot connect, and back come the Crabbers down by six. This is Shanda Bailey feeding down low for Stephanie Hicks. When they can get the pass into her, that's almost an automatic.
Well, if she can get the ball down there, the only way you're going to stop her is to foul her or to double team her. And right now, all they're doing is playing her heads up. But nice shot by Holcraft.
Colleen Holcraft with the basket. And now the turnover gives the ball back to Mansfield. Monarchs fired up, miss everything, but Holcraft does not. Her follow shot gives Mansfield an 8-point lead. Hampton does not want to get into a basket trading situation because they will not win a game like that against Mansfield. They just don't have the firepower. Torrey Howard finds Stephanie Hicks. She's guarded by Lias. Hicks showing that she not only can use the glass, but she can go with a soft touch as well.
Well, that shows you she can play with her back to the basket and facing the basket. Very versatile, this young lady.
Speaking of versatile, here's another one. Holcraft this time doesn't draw iron, and it's last touched out of bounds by Shanda Bailey. Lias can't get it. Follow shot, no good, but a foul. And it looks like it'll be against Lassiter.
I'm thinking same thing, Tim. Number four, you got to get her out of there, and that's exactly what David Six is doing.
So she will check out of the game, and Fennell will check in. Katrina Fennell, who played a good number of minutes in the first half, played well, too. Fennell, a 6-foot sophomore, has a great future ahead of her for David Six's troops. Patricia Dixon hits the first of two free throws. Short on the second one, but the rebound comes off to Lias. Shot no good. Tip out to Misty Hart. Holcraft, short. And a tie up. Jump ball and a possession arrow will give the ball to the Monarchs. You're watching the championship game, Peninsula District Girls Basketball, coming to you from Anderson Fieldhouse at Fort Eustis. I'm Tim Cole along with Bob Hintz. Hope you're enjoying the game. Misty Hart traveled before the shot, they say.
Well, you'd see that Hampton is going to stay in that zone to try to neutralize the quick offense of this Monarch team, but I tell you, their defense is just awesome. They steal, I don't know how many steals they've had tonight.
Monarchs move the ball around nicely, but the shot comes up a little short. Torrey Howard will bring it up. Guarded by Holcraft. Not enough contact to draw a foul. Shanda Bailey with a crossover dribble, and it has it stolen by Holcraft. Holcraft in front of the field for the easy basket. So Colleen Holcraft has come alive here, and the turnover created by Holcraft. And then we've got a traveling as unable to keep her balance was Patricia Dixon. Checking back in for Hampton will be Leslie Jones, number 33. She'll replace Fennell on the short bench that David Six has. He did bring up some players from the JVs for the tournament, but he went with eight during the regular season, eight regular players on the varsity squad.
And that's all he played with all year long, and that's he's done just a remarkable job. Tim, it's tough to practice with only eight, but him and his JV coach would get out there and be the other two players.
Good looking shot by Leos. Stephanie Hicks, good savvy. She felt the pressure of the defender. Ooh, and did she throw a shoulder into Patricia Dixon? Gracious me.
Well, she's going to say, well, I'll set a screen, and she did.
Boy, I mean, she just popped her. And Dixon smiled at her, looked and said, hey, what did I do to deserve that?
You scored too many points.
Well, you know, we talked about, and probably too much already, but Hicks not only has that never say die attitude, but she's got that competitive spirit you can see in her eyes. 4:40 left here in the third period. 11-point lead for the Monarchs. They led by six at halftime. But this young lady that just shot the ball has helped undo that. And now Leos will get an extra attempt, as the foul will be charged to Leslie Jones.
She does a great job, offensive rebounds to Lois Leos. Just is in the right place, and then she keeps the ball up above her head, which is, if you'll note, a lot of the taller guys and gals will get the ball, they'll bring it down, so then that negates their height. She doesn't. She keeps the ball up above, rebounds, keeps it up there, and goes right back up with it. Good coaching and good fundamentals by this young lady.
Leos missed the first of two. There you see a good look at the talented freshman. 9 points so far unofficially. So Lassiter comes back in. David Six realizes that four fouls are no fouls. He has to have her on the court to have a chance. So I think it makes sense to play her at this point. She can't help you on the bench.
You got that right. But she's got to watch her fouls.
Stephanie Hicks cleared out nicely for her teammate Bailey, but Bailey held up the dribble instead and then lost it. And then Dixon can't control it on the baseline.
Great job by Torrey Howard that time to knock that ball off of the defense or the offensive player.
Hart steals the ball and scores. So Misty Hart has 7 points, and the lead now expanding all the way to 14. And Torrey Howard can't control it.
A little bit of contact.
really good defense played by Mitchell. They really know how to guard you and not really commit that many fouls.
They do a good job with their feet, Tim. They get good position, and that's what you got to do.
Now, you know, that's what Phil Forbes teaches, and they've been good students. Leos not ready for the pass, took it right on the nose. Hampton now coming out of that zone a bit. Looks like they're playing maybe a 2-3.
It's exactly what they're playing, and they're trying to open it up. And right there is the reason why. Because they want to get the ball inside. And the best way to get it inside is to open up that middle. Try to draw the zone out.
Fennell in, Lassiter out for Hampton. 3:08 left. Mansfield by 14, make that 16. -19 in favor of Mansfield. And the turnover and the foul. Shanda Bailey, a little frustrated, reached in and committed the foul.
Stephanie Hicks, Tim, works. And sometimes the pass isn't good or whatever, but you never see a look of disgust on her face. I mean, she doesn't get down. She just, okay, we'll go down, play defense, come back down and try it again.
Saw a wide shot of the field house here. This court bigger than these players are used to. A couple of things are distracting about this facility that the players are not used to. And of course, the wide open spaces in the Hampton and the Mitchellville gyms, you have rather close quarters. You have no room behind the baskets. And then the other factor is you have the scoreboards at either end of the schools, whereas here it's in the middle of the court. So these things tend to make seemingly more difference than you might imagine.
This size of court is a lot of difference in because it's not only bigger, but then it's even looks bigger because of the spaces you were talking about.
Our director, Scotty Bowers, fooling us here, said we weren't going to have instant replay here in the first game, but he popped a couple in on us there.
Well, he's doing a little of both. I tell you, Scotty is something else.
So Misty Hart hits both free throws, and then the Crabbers throw it away. So that defense just continues to wear you down. There you see Phil Forbes, cowboy boots and all. A definite trademark of Phil. He's I think he swims with those things on.
Well, it gives him a little more height. He hates to look up to his girls, but when he's got some gals out there 6 foot and a better, he's going to look up at them.
And a turnover on a traveling call. That lead just continuing to expand. Now it's out to an 18-point difference. And another turnover. So the turnovers just continue. Phil Forbes congratulates Misty Hart for causing the turnover. Good play down low. That's the kind of play that will take this team a lot further than the regionals if they can get the big girl down low to get that entry pass and then the easy basket. When you add the outside shooting that this Mitchell team has, they're going to be awesome. Tori Howard has it blocked by Leos, but she saved it to a Hampton player. Now Tori will fire and hit.
That's the way you got to do it. Don't get frustrated because they block a shot. You get it, shoot it again.
39-21, less than a minute and 40 seconds to go. And Leos is making her presence.
Great entry pass by
known.
Great entry pass by Misty Hart that time.
That's what that senior experience will do for you. This team has been all the way to the state finals as they were last year. Did not win it, but an awful lot of people were impressed.
The easy ones sometimes are the ones that get away, Tim.
Hampton is going to take a timeout with 1:09 to go in the third period.
And as we have the timeout, let me again mention that we will select a player of the game from the Hampton Crabbers from the Hampton Crabbers team tonight. The Sports Place and DC Engraving help us recognize them with a plaque and a shirt. And Dave Chubb at the Sports Place, located on Big Bethel Road at Hampton Woods Plaza.
As you watch some of the replay there, you saw Torrey Howard shot. I didn't mean to interrupt you, but
that's okay.
Slip one in there.
They give us the T-shirt, and of course the plaque comes from DC Engraving from Dave Buchwalter up there on Route 17 in Tabb Square. Again, we thank them and thank Dave Chubb for our sweatshirts that we have on.
.109 remaining here in the third period. 41-21, the biggest lead of the night, a 20-point difference for the Monarchs.
As we turn around and show them your shirt, Tim.
Hi, Mom. gotta get Mom cable. And a shot put up. And a foul is called.
Foul is going to be against the Lady Monarchs, number 32-1, the hardest. That's going to be her fourth personal foul.
She's got four, Tim, but she's the one that's been guarding this young lady that you see right there on the screen, Stephanie Hicks. And, of course, when your offense is designed to get the ball into her, it puts a lot of pressure on a defensive ball player.
A good look at Stephanie Hicks. And she is a really excellent ball player. Got a heart as big as the world. However, she'd trade that right now for a couple of free throws that wouldn't go.
Well, she got the first one.
The ball will belong to Menchville. Pass cannot be caught by Leas as we're under 30 seconds to go in the third period. Now next week, the playoffs in the regional play start in earnest as Menchville and Hampton will advance to regional play. Hampton will travel to the Beach District, I believe it is, to play Salem. Oh, and that'll be fun. As Lassiter can't get it to drop.
And Salem is the top team on the other side, and of course, Menchville will host the game over here.
Torrey Howard as the buzzer sounds to end the third period with a desperation shot. But our score now is 41-22 as Menchville put 20 points on the board and only 7 for the Crabbers in that third period. So they broke it wide open there.
Well, they're not rushing their shots as much. They're getting the ball underneath the basket to Lois. They're controlling the ball in that they're not even letting the Crabbers get the ball inbound sometimes. There's a lot of turnovers because of that defense. Good shot of Gordon White to the left corner. Your picture there is assistant principal over at Hampton High School. There he is pointing. And you know, you gotta feel pretty good if you're David Six, because your girls are playing good ball once they get the ball into their end of the court. Their problem is they're not getting the ball at the end of the court, and there's a shot of our boss, the superintendent, Mr. Raymond Washington.
Oh, I thought my wife was here. I don't know about you, but my boss.
Well, in terms of what we're doing, Tim, not in terms of your everyday life.
I got you now. I got you. All right, 8 minutes remaining in the game.
Please come up and pick up your ball from the team out. We need to have those fouls turned.
I remind you that we will be picking the player of the game from the Hampton School. Right now, it's a pretty clear-cut choice. Shanda Bailey trying to get it to her teammate Hicks down low, but she's being heavily guarded. Now she gets it to Hicks. Hicks in traffic, put it up, no good. And the rebound taken down by Rietta Williams, one of the seniors on Phil Forbes' squad. Misty Hart can't get it to her teammate Williams across the court, and the ball will come back to Hampton.
Well, she tried to pass that off the dribble. The ball come up a lot higher than she was ready for.
This is good experience for Hampton to be playing a team of the caliber of Metzville. They won't face someone much less accurate in that Salem girls team next week.
There you saw right there.
Misty Hart with the left-handed jumper. Knocked out of bounds by Holcraft. All belongs to Hampton. Join us late, the Lady Crabbers and the Monarchs in a low-scoring first quarter. Hampton trailed 7-3 and then pretty much matched Metzville during the second quarter to trail only 6 points at halftime, 21-15. But a 20-7 burst in the third period by Metzville has broken this game open. And now the Lady Monarchs are lighting it up. Misty Hart has 15 points.
Well, if you can't do anything else, you get it to Stephanie and let her bring it up.
Shanda Bailey's shot too strong. Rebound is chased down by Lassiter. Lost on the baseline. It'll belong to Hampton. Again, we want to thank the fine folks here at Fort Eustis for all of their assistance in not only for this game, but the two previous games we did in Mike Cicero, Ron Lynch, and Don Tillison. We certainly want to express our thanks to these gentlemen for all of their help. Our crew was aided incredibly by them, not to mention the fact that they allowed us to leave our cables down over the game between the game Wednesday and tonight, so saved the crew a lot of work. And you know, when we talk about our crews, there is a lot of work that goes into these games that you and I just walk in and everything's set up and we just go with it. But the crew gets here, you know, 4 or 5 hours ahead of time and has to run a lot of cable and snake away their way around as we watch some replay of that last action. So, again, we appreciate the fine job the crew does. We mentioned their names before, so we don't want them to get swollen heads here. We don't want to get too much. Except that Miss Petaway, she's the hardest worker.
Oh, I tell you, Bianca is the one we need to give more recognition to.
My director just told me something. I don't know if I can repeat it, but I didn't hear it. So. Triple fives left in the time box here. There you see the difference, 21 points. The Metzville Monarchs on the way to their 24th victory without a loss this season. What a tremendous season for Metzville, and kind of was expected because they were state finalists last year.
Well, I'll tell you what, we're getting into replay now. I see Ron Baton's got the camera at the end, so that means Jerome Young is in the truck doing the instant replay.
That explains it.
See, I was giving Scotty a lot of credit running back and forth.
Which would be no easy task for Scotty to do in that truck. Shanda Bailey hits the first of two. Neither team even close to the limit here. Three fouls for Metzville as a team, four for Hampton. And Bailey misses on the second. Nice feed down low for Bircher. So Leah shows her passing ability as well. See that anticipation coming. Patricia Dixon watching the movement of the ball, and you can see her just anticipating that next pass. Almost got it.
Well, that's what makes a good defensive player, and thinking like an offensive player. Where would I put the ball? How would I bounce it to him?
Stephanie Hicks' shot is short. Back come the Monarchs. And it's stolen by Latoya Lassiter. We remind you that in addition to this game, Channel 5 will also be bringing you the championship game between Ferguson and Kecoughtan. Game 4 in that series, Ferguson holds the edge 2-1. And Hicks banks it in from the free throw line.
Off of the board.
19 points for Stephanie, right at her average. Leos, no good. Follow shot.
Great good. Rebound.
Almost. Foul is called.
Number 14, Carol Williams, did a great job, just a 5'8 junior. Difference of sitting there waiting for the ball to come to you and going to it. She went to the ball.
There you see Phil Forbes on the bench there, coaching along with his assistants. Williams misses the first of two. Hits the second. .420 left. Stephanie Hicks again.
She's
21 showing, points.
Showing some versatility. She's taking an outside jumper. They're having trouble getting the ball inside. That's what you do.
And Hicks with another rebound. So you know she's got a double-double going. Had 10 rebounds at halftime. Any more people walk by us with that popcorn, they're going to lose that bag of popcorn.
I was wondering, it's smelling better all the time.
The aroma here at the Anderson Fieldhouse, they got pizza, and they got popcorn, and they got hot dogs. And it's too late because you didn't get out here if you're watching this game and didn't show up. Like my friend Margie and Bill Johnson and their daughter Stephanie, they were here again tonight. Came out here, they were out here Wednesday night, and they drove all the way from Fox Hill.
Well, that's a good place to come from. That's down there where I live.
Or was it or somewhere in Hampton? I'm assuming it was Fox Hill, but big Hampton fans. Gilliam's attempted three doesn't go. Stephanie Hicks on the follow shot draws the foul.
Nose for the ball, Tim, working all the time, and she does not come out. I can't remember when I've seen a Hampton game, especially this year, that Stephanie Hicks came out of the game.
Forgive me if you mentioned it. Are you aware by any chance of where she might be going to play ball in college? Is she any word on where she might be going?
Well, she's just a junior.
Just a junior. Never mind. I was trying to put her in the senior category.
No, don't.
That's why you never mentioned it.
David Six would be over here talking to
you. Yeah, well, I said earlier she was a junior.
Yeah.
Then I forgot, but she plays like a senior.
Yeah,
so
she really does.
.17 bulge, and Hicks playing like it was a two-point difference, lunging and diving for the ball, but you can't come up with it.
I mean, you got to be impressed the way Menchfield passes the ball to the open player. They know that if they're double teaming on one side, somebody's on the other side. They move the ball around real quick against this trapping defense that the Crabbers are throwing at them right now, and they do a great job of moving the ball.
Wanda Artis at the free throw line. She is 3 of 4 from the charity stripe. That came in the first half. She misses her first attempt here in the second. Traveling call.
And you know, Tim, the one time that you're not pressured bringing the ball up, you stop your dribble to pass it, the player doesn't break to it, you pull your pivot foot. Those are the kind of turnovers that gives the coach gray hair, or in your case, lose it.
Right, gray hair or no hair. Less than 3 minutes to go. Misty Hart finds Leos from 17, short with the shot. And Gilliam with the rebound. But her outlet pass and Stephanie Hicks went down hard. Got hit in the face, and Hicks just bounces right up like it was nothing.
That's a tough girl, too. And is there any doubt in your mind who will play the player of the game tonight?
No.
Okay.
No, really not.
Stephanie Hicks, I kind of... She's been knocked around. And
no foul was called.
No, he did call a foul.
Did
he called a foul, yeah.
Okay. I was going to say. So Dixon picks up her fourth foul. And Hicks never missed a second. Gilliam spots Hicks. Hicks for
nice
the
nice pass from Gilliam. Great job of looking for the open player.
Now, Gilliam is just a junior, too. I see a real future for David Six's squad next year. Shanda Bailey, the second leading scorer on the team, will be back. As I mentioned, the only loss will be Tori Howard, and certainly her play will be missed. But they've got a wealth of players coming back next year for this Hampton squad.
Well, Tori is the captain of the team. She is the only senior on the team. And she has come a long way. She has developed in quite a ball handler herself.
Shanda Bailey picks up the personal foul. That's her third. At the free throw line, Wanda Artis. And Wanda Artis, good with both free throws. 50-33. The only thing in question is the final score. Gilliam with the bank shot. So Nakisha Gilliam gets her first points of the game. 15-point difference. Misty Hart is fouled on her way to the basket.
And well, it'll be a shooting foul at this point, but I mean, because of the 1-1.
And this will be against the Lady Crabbers, number 32, Nakisha Gilliam. That is her third personal foul
on Nakisha Gilliam. And as you mentioned, Bob, that is the seventh team foul against the Crabbers. So 1-1 is the order of the day for Misty Hart. She is 3 of 4 from the free throw line, and she has 15 points. Here you saw the replay of the foul. And Misty will get the bonus. So Hart after missing her second free throw, has hit four in a row now. Less than 2 minutes to play. Tori Howard hits, yes, and a foul away from the shot. I believe the basket will count. Tori Howard now with 4 points. And a foul against. So Stephanie Hicks pushing off as the shot went in. So because it was a simultaneous play, the basket will count by Howard.
That's correct.
And at the other end of the court, we'll have one and one for Wanda Artis.
At the line to shoot for Lady Monarchs, number 32, Wanda Artis.
Wanda has been to the free throw line a total of 8 times now, make that 9. And she has hit 6 of those 9. So she's doing a fine job from the charity stripe. Another mark of a good team is you hit your free throws. Gotta hit them. Good rotation on the ball. Won't go this time, however.
Well, Tim, at the end of the game, they will be announcing the selection for the all-tournament team. We will pick that up. Just want to let the fans know that there will be, that will come at the end of this game.
Hicks got the roll. Stephanie Hicks. 27 points unofficially for Stephanie Hicks. Gee, I wonder if she'll make the team.
But she just got a block shot that time.
Think she might be on that all-district, all-tournament team?
If she doesn't make it, we better check the ballots.
Got a jump ball there, an arrow possession. Gives the ball to Mintzville, and Leos is fouled on the play by Fennell. Katrina Fennell, her second. Patricia Dixon is going to check out, and in her place will come Carol Williams. Saw some of the action there.
The young lady's got quite a future. She shoots the foul shots good. She rebounds real well. Just a freshman. You got to be impressed.
She works the low post. She shoots from outside. Does everything but blow up the ball, so that's the kind of player you look for.
That's frustration. I can't believe you'd do that.
Got a technical foul. That'll be the 4th on Fennell. And she'll check out of the game, and Nicole Heath will make her first appearance, number 52. But you can't do that. You can't slam the ball down in disgust. And it wasn't terribly blatant.
No,
they could have let that one
at
go.
This point in the game, you kind of let that go by. Yeah. You warn her and say, hey, you know, you do it again, that's a technical. Just do a little coach, a little help there on themselves. That's what they need to do.
And now Colleen Holcraft will check out, and Karen Felix will replace her. So 1 of 2 for Misty Hart. And of course, the rule will also give the ball to Mintzville at half court. And Talois Leos will come out and draw hugs from the coaches and players alike for her fine effort tonight. Ball kicked out of bounds by a Lady Kraber. Stolen on the inbounds pass by, guess who? Stephanie Hicks. Less than a minute to go. Tanisha McDonald in the game now for Hampton, as both coaches going to the benches.
Foul is going to be against the Lady Monarchs, number 32, Wanda Artis. That's going to be her fifth personal foul.
Get a chance to watch a little of the action here. Compliments of Jerome, not so young. And you saw the reach-in foul committed by Wanda Artis.
And number 42,
LaKenya Parker.
Hey, can't read my own writing. I don't write big enough.
Gets her own rebound, but throws it up a little too strong. Good lead pass down the court for the easy basket. Amiko Perry with the first score of the game for Miss Perry. Hicks for three, no good. A loose ball picked up by the Monarchs. It is good by Carol Williams. 21-point lead for Menchville, 60-39. Hicks again for three, short. And knocked out of bounds by the Lady Crabbers. Just 8 seconds remaining. But again, this is not the end of the season for anyone. The Hampton Crabbers will travel to play the Salem girls team from Virginia Beach. Got a traveling call. Gary Melvin getting a chance to see a little action here coming up from the JV team. 3 seconds to go. And the Menchville Monarchs will host a game, and we invite you and encourage you to come on out and support. Travel with the Lady Crabbers if you can. And certainly there's no reason for anyone not to come out and watch the Menchville Monarchs host a game on Tuesday night. Shot at the buzzer doesn't go. And the final score, the Menchville Monarchs win the championship as well as the regular season title by the final score of 60-39. And our choice for player of the game will be Stephanie Hicks. A tough choice. Not at all. Let me see if I can do some quick tabulation on Stephanie here. Got her unofficially with 27 points on the night. And as Bob mentioned, we will get a quick word with David Six, I think. Bob? I guess not. Nope, I thought Bob was going to try and Bill. Okay, so we will use the mic for the awards. Bill Nelms, I believe, will be the person that we will give that task to as we wait here for the awards. I'll run down the scoring. Lassiter had 1 point for Hampton. Gilliam, 2 points. Unofficially, 27 for Stephanie Hicks. 5 points for Shanda Bailey. 4 points for Tori Howard for their total of 39. Misty Hart, after having a 5-point first half, added 11 more for a 16-point unofficial total. 2 points for Patricia Dixon, 5 points for Carol Williams, 8 points for Colleen Holcraft, 2 points for Amiko Perry, as well as Shannon Bircher. For Wanda Artis, She had 5 points in the first half and added three in the second half unofficially for eight. And Choloyes Lias, and I hope I mispronounced her name only once or twice tonight. She had six at halftime and added nine more for a total of 15 points unofficially for her contribution to this game. As you look at David Six and Tori Howard and the rest of the Lady Crabbers on the sideline as we await. And now we'll go to Bill Nelms for the announcements. Don't believe Bill has our microphone.
Well, he's got it over there. If he's not going to pick it up, I can't go over and give it to him.
Director, his assistant is Mr. Ray Ellison. Ray is to my left. Now, ladies and gentlemen, let me tell you that Mr. Leach and Mr. Ellison had this particular year's tournament was extremely difficult. As you probably well know, the weather didn't cooperate with us a whole lot. We had games to play tonight. We were supposed to hold the tournament meeting. It was not held. Mr. Lynch and Mr. Ellison spent a great deal of time on the phone putting this together and getting us to where we are tonight. And besides doing that, which is a monstrous job, they still managed to get everything done during the course of the day that the school demanded. Gentlemen, that was a tremendous job. Some other folks behind the scenes before we pass out the awards that we would like to acknowledge, that these folks worked tirelessly throughout. They have worked throughout this tournament as well as others. We would like to call attention to Charles Sills and Diane Ellison. These are the two folks that you saw immediately.
Well, Tim, he's not using our microphone, so
our director said we'd just pick him up on our mics.
Okay.
And Cheryl Williams, these are the two folks that you ran into as soon as you came into our gym here this evening. At this time, we'd like to, if we could, call out a representative, or Bill Thorpe, if he would come out from the Peninsula District regular season champion, that he might already have been built and receive the district trophy. This is the one that earned the Lady Monarchs the automatic berth in the Eastern Regional. And now we'd like to ask David Six, or a member.
That was the awarding of the regular season district championship trophy.
The second representative from the Peninsula District as they move on to regional competition.
Tori Howard as the captain for the Lady Crabbers. Good shot.
Once again, we need a representative from the Lady Monarchs. This will be the Peninsula District Tournament Championship.
District tournament team.
Well, we got you now, Bill.
First up will be a 5'8" junior guard for the Mitchellville Lady Monarchs. Didn't play tonight. She had 19 against the Bethel Bruins, 6 against the Lafayette Lady Rams, number 23, Danielle Dawson.
Danielle, of course, did not play tonight because she is ill, but she's well enough to get her plaque.
Next on this year's all-tournament team is a 6'1" freshman center. She scored 18 against the Bethel Bruins, scored 18 also against the Lady Rams, scored 13 tonight against the Lady Crabbers. From the Mitchellville Lady Monarchs, number 33, Choloyes Lias.
You'll see a lot of that young lady.
Next on the all-tournament team pick is a 5'9" junior guard. This lady scored 10 against the Denby Patriots, six against the Phoebus Phantoms, six here this evening, representing the Lady Crabbers of Hampton, number 44, Shauna Bailey. Next up was a 5'9" junior guard. This lady scored 23 points against Gloucester, 16 in a losing effort against the Lady Crabbers of Hampton. Representing the Phoebus Lady Phantoms, number 34, Wayne Adavini. What a performance this lady had here tonight, a 5'10" junior forward. 19 against the Phoebus Phantoms. 21 against the Denby Patriots. 27 tonight against the Lady Monarchs of Benchville. The leading rebounder in the game with 15 from the Hampton Lady Crabbers, number 34, Stephanie Hicks.
Incredible numbers, Tim.
27 points, 15 rebounds in this game alone. Bill Forbes goes over to congratulate her.
The most valuable player for this year's tournament goes to a 5'11" senior forward. She had 10 against the Bethel Bruins, 12 against the Lafayette Rams, 18 tonight against the Lady Crabbers of Hampton. It goes to the Mitchell Lady Monarchs, number 3, Misty Hart.
Kind of wraps it up, Jeff.
That does it. So your all-tournament team and your most valuable player, Misty Hart, for the Mintsville Monarchs. So again, we want to thank all the folks here at Fort Eustis for all of their assistance. And we strongly encourage you to come out and support the Monarchs and the Lady Crabbers in their quest to go further in the regional playoffs. The final score again, the Mintsville Monarchs win the tournament as well as the regular season champion, 60-39 over the Lady Crabbers. For Bob Hintz, this is Tim Cole. Thanks for watching. Good night, everybody.
Is that all right? I didn't.